In this video, I'll show you exactly how to use ChatGPT to create a professional and engaging presentation step by step. If you're new here, I'm Aga. I run an online education business with more than 1.5 million followers across my social media. And on this channel, I share my top tips on AI, content, and productivity. So hit the subscribe button and let's get this video started. So first, go to ChatGPT. If you haven't used it before, just sign up for the free version. And then you'll be adding your prompts into this box. Ask ChatGPT to assume the role of somebody who's very experienced in the subject that your presentation is about. For example, assume the role of a very experienced marketing manager for the rest of this conversation. Then describe the presentation topic and goal. What are you trying to achieve? Maybe you're trying to make a sale or convince your boss to go ahead with a new project. Define that goal in your prompt. For example, I need to create a presentation about the benefits of influencer marketing to convince the director of marketing to increase the influencer marketing budget and approve a new campaign. Sometimes it may also be appropriate to describe the learning outcome of the presentation. If it has an educational angle, for example, if you're running a workshop or delivering a training session. For example, I need to create a presentation for a workshop about influencer marketing strategies and best practice. The learning outcome is for the audience to be able to create a step-by-step plan for their next influencer campaign. Next, you define the audience, who they are, what their user needs are, what level of expertise they have, because you want to pitch it at the right level. For example, my audience is a senior executive who has no prior knowledge of influencer marketing and very little experience of working with social media. Define the tone and length of your presentation. For example, I need a 10-slide presentation that's very formal and uses a very serious tone. Your next step is to generate the outline of the presentation. So you can see I've already entered all of the things that I've mentioned into the prompt box. And now I'm just going to add the final bit of the prompt, which is create a slide outline for this presentation. Include a title, main point, and subpoints for each slide. So let's see what it comes up with. It's given me a title, a main point, and some subpoints for each slide, which is exactly what I needed. And then what you can do is you can go through those things and see if anything doesn't look right, if you want to add anything. You can copy and paste it into a separate document, work with it, and then you can paste it back into ChatGPT if you want to make any adjustments. So for example, I'm just going to make one amendment to this. I'm going to say for slide 8, don't include concerns, but just risks, and rewrite this outline. So it's going to regenerate the outline with that one change that I've asked for. So when we get to slide 8, you can see that it's been amended and it just covers risks and not concerns, which is great. Next, you're going to ask for the slide content. So your prompt could be write the content for each slide in bullet points based on the outline. And here you can also add something into your prompt to specify the style or tone of the language, like make it professional but engaging, or use simple language for a non-technical audience. You can also specify how many words you want on each slide, like keep it to 50 words maximum per slide. So now I'm going to ask ChatGPT to write the content for each slide in bullet points based on the outline. And let's see what it comes up with. So the bullet points have been expanded slightly and it looks closer to what I actually need for my slides. You could, of course, be doing all of these things in one prompt. So you could ask for the outline and the content of the slides all at once, but sometimes there are some changes you need to make or you need to re-prompt ChatGPT. For example, if the outline it's given you is too basic or not very original. So to be more efficient, do it step by step ask for the outline first and then ask for the content. That way you can make some amendments and then continue to work with something that you're actually happy with. Your next step is to add speaker notes. Write speaker notes for each slide to explain the content in a natural speaking voice. So this is what it looks like when I enter the prompt. It's going to go ahead and actually write me the speaker notes. It's given me a very useful draft to work from. Of course, I'm going to make some adjustments to this, but a lot of these ideas can actually be really helpful and I may well end up using them in the actual presentation. Sometimes the best, most engaging presentations are actually quite basic without much text at all. So the speaker notes can actually be the most important part of your presentation. You might want to spend some time on this one, refining the prompt, defining the tone, adding some jokes, anecdotes, or personal stories. And I've got a separate video about how exactly you can make AI-generated content sound more like a human wrote it. So your next step is to ask ChatGPT for design and visual suggestions. So your prompt could be, suggest appropriate images, icons, or charts for each slide. So I want to show you how I would do this. And as you're doing it yourself, you might want to experiment with different approaches, different prompts, and different ways of doing this. But this is how I would personally do this. So I would use this prompt and suggest images, icons, or charts for a specific slide. So let's say we're going to focus on slide 8, which is about risks and how to manage them. And ChatGPT has actually given me a verbal description of how I could design the slide or what images I could include on it. But if you want to see a specific image, then you can also ask for that too. But this is what it's come up with. So this is just some brainstorming to give you ideas. You may actually end up using some of the images, but you might not. If you don't, you can just use those ideas that ChatGPT gives you and then prompt again for more specific images. And I've got separate videos about how to create images with ChatGPT and how to structure your prompts to get the best results. And finally, step number 6 is all about exporting your presentation to PowerPoint or Google Slides. If you're using the free version of ChatGPT, you can just copy and paste the content into your slides. If you're using the paid version of ChatGPT, then you can ask it to export the content automatically into a PowerPoint file, then download it, and then open it in Google Slides if that's what you want to be using. If you want to convert it straight into a PowerPoint file, that's what you would do. And it's actually going to give you a download. So this is what it's come up with. So here we go. That's the file. Let's download it. And then because I actually really like using Google Slides, so I'm just going to go ahead and upload it directly into a slide deck in Google Slides. And so this is what it's come up with. So it's literally just transferred the content into each slide. And we've got it formatted as bullet points already. And then you can obviously very easily edit the content from here. There are also more advanced ways to do this, like using a script, but that's a topic for another video. If this video helped you, let me know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Bye.